Welcome back, my dear friends. We entered into last day of Devi Navaratri celebrations. So what a wonderful journey. We recite and remind so much from these 9 days. Today, we enter into the 9th day of Devi Navaratri celebration. And before start today's wisdom, I would like to pay my heartfelt tributes to my mom and my Guruji Brahmarshi Pitamaha Patriji to giving this wonderful knowledge to me. So welcome, my dear friends. Today, goddess name is Siddhidhatri Devi. So Mata Siddhidhatri Devi. Mata Siddhidhatri represents energies of perfection and enlightenment. Perfection and enlightenment. What a wonderful energies, my dear friends. Perfection means, what is perfection? Doing all things with righteousness, like you're talking, your words you are using, and emotions, everything with that righteousness. To attain perfection, we need practice of awareness, my dear friends. Only through we attain perfection, to unlock this divine energy, Mata Siddhidhatri energy within us, we need to practice awareness, be aware. When you be aware, you are able to do right things. Whenever you are not aware, you just talk like that. You give your opinions, pass judgments without awareness, my friends. So awareness is the key to achieve this perfection, this righteousness in our life. Otherwise, we just ended up with point others, point out others. That's it. We didn't learn anything. But with awareness, we understand our own mistakes, so we correct ourselves, so we become perfect and we attain that righteousness in our life. And coming to enlightenment, Siddhidhatri Devi, another energy is enlightenment, means living with divine qualities and clarity. The Divya Jnana Prakas. We took birth to attain this enlightenment, attain this state. The whole journey of our this Devi Navaratri, our whole journey is to reach this state, my dear friends, enlightened state. It is also called Mukti, Moksham, Salvation, Liberation, Apavarga. So many names are there for this enlightenment. But our ultimate goal is to attain this Mukti, attain this Moksha state, Nirvana state. This is our actual state, but we totally forget of our true self because of ignorance and Maya, illusions. Again, now we are re-empty in our true state. Enlightenment is not in a, or a not a place to go and reach, or not a goal. The once you reach there and then it's done, not like that once. Once you reached, everything is over. Not like that. We need to understand enlightenment in a better way. Understand there is no end to learn. Understanding there is no end to learning, and learning is a continuous process. By knowing that, if you do that process of learning with joyful and enjoyment, that is enlightenment. Enlightenment is experiencing divinity within ourselves and everyone around you. That is enlightenment. And respecting and accepting people and everyone as they are is enlightenment. Learning from every situation in your life is enlightenment. Learning from everyone around you is enlightenment. Enlightenment is all about living in this present moment. And I suggest you to understand really well about this enlightened state. Please listen to Brahmarshi Pitamaha Patriji audio about enlightenment. There is two parts of audios about enlightenment. I believe it is available in PSSM website. So go through that website and listen to that audio, what is enlightenment, described by Brahmarshi Pitamaha Patriji. It's a wonderful audio. By listening to that, we came to know what is enlightenment. Guruji explained wonderfully about the state, how we are when we get when we attain that enlightened state. And today, goddess name is Siddhidatri. Siddhidatri Devi also represents, her name itself represents Siddhi, right? Siddhi means supernatural powers. So, I prefer to use word Siddhi instead of supernatural powers because it is comfortable and make more sense for me. So, while explaining this concept, I use the word Siddhi. Siddhi means that power, supernatural powers kind of stuff, okay? So, we have many kinds of powers like telepathy, television, astral travel, clairvoyance, clairaudience, psychometry, clairsentience, intuition, and so many other kind of powers. And being without, able to be without food, sustain ourselves without taking any food. In our scriptures, we listen about Ashtasiddhis, right? There is many kinds of Siddhis. Let me explain this Ashtasiddhis. These are main eight Siddhis. There is hundreds of Siddhis, my dear friends. We are not able to describe all those Siddhis here. But mainly, we listen about Ashtasiddhis from our scriptures and Puranas. So I will try to describe these Ashtasiddhis. Because in our spiritual practice, we may get this. I'll explain what is this Siddhi, how we get them, and how we need to use them to understand, by understanding that we get so much of clarity. Okay. So these Siddhis are like Anima Siddhi, Mahima Siddhi, Garima Siddhi, and Lagima Siddhi, Prapti Siddhi, Prakamya Siddhi, Ishitva Siddhi, Vasitva Siddhi. Again, one more time. Anima, Mahima, Garima, Lagima, Prapti, Prakamya, Ishitva, Vashitva, Siddhis. So these are eight Siddhis we called as Ashtasiddhis. So coming to first, Anima Siddhi. Anima Siddhi means becoming small like a cell. And Mahima Siddhi, second one is Mahima Siddhi. Mahima Siddhi like the ability to become like a mountain. The best example for these Siddhis are the Lord Hanuma. When he tried to find the Mata Sita, he became small and using this Anima Siddhi. And when we, and then doing the battle and protecting Rama and all those in that battle time, war time, he became big like a mountain while getting that the medicine for Lakshmana. So in those times, he became like a mountain, big. That is Mahima Siddhi. So Garima Siddhi means big, and that is Anima Siddhi, Mahima Siddhi. So these Siddhis are also attained through our astral body, not only our physical body. Sometimes these Siddhis we get these Siddhis through our astral bodies. With our astral body, sometimes we enter into our body and we enter into our cell. We enter into one water drop. So that is Anima Siddhi. We became like a little Anu and we entered into those body moleculars, DNA, and we were able to see what happened there, what kind of changes, how our body it is reacting and building. So that is Anima Siddhi. Not that means you have to attain with your physical body. You may attain with your astral body. And sometimes you may attain this with your the Mahima, Garima Siddhi also attained by your astral body. You become big like anything and you can see all over you, like little things. So this is Anima and Mahima Siddhi. Coming to another Siddhis, Garima Siddhi. The third one is Garima. Garima Siddhi means become heavy. Many yogis. So coming to third Siddhi. This Garima Siddhi. Garima Siddhi means becoming heavy, and Lagima. Lagima Siddhi means becoming light like anything. Many yogis walk on water and fly in the air using this Lagima Siddhi. Okay, and coming to Garima Siddhi, I will remind you one wonderful story of Lord Krishna to give an example about Garima Siddhi. Do you remember the Sri Krishna Tulabharam? Satyabhama Devi tried to weigh him with gold and in gold with that incident, like with gold and jewels, garments, everything. But he became very heavy, even though she put all her gold and gems, jewels, everything, she can't weigh Lord Krishna. But when Rukmini Devi gave to try to weigh him with a basil troop, he became light, very light, and he became equal to that basil leaves weight. So this is how Garima Siddhi and Lagima Siddhi will work on difference. And coming to Prapti and Prakamya. Prapti means the mastery and control over our senses. Prakamya means power to achieve anything. I will try to give some example for these siddhis too. Like we listen about saints. So many saints, they can be underwater. And it is also called Vayusthambana Vidya. And some other great yogis live without food. For example, Mummudivaram Bali Yogi, he lived entire his life without eating any food. And a lady called Jasmohinin from Australia, she's still there and she stopped eating food from many years and managing herself and her life only by prana energy. So this is how Prapti Siddhi work. And Prakamya Siddhi means you can achieve anything you intended for. If you intended anything for your own selfish desires, this siddhi will vanish. This siddhi will vanish from your energy system. We should intend for higher good. So that is Prapti, Prakamya Siddhis. And coming to Ishitva and Vasitva. Ishitva Siddhi means the power of creation. If you got this siddhi, we could create things. For example, we listen to many stories about how yogis will create things. For example, Siddhi Sai Baba and Vishwamitra Maharshi. Vishwamitra Maharshi, he created a realm, right? And Siddhi Sai Baba created, and Satya Sai Baba created some lingas from his hand. Like that, they able to create whatever, small things to big things, they able to create, right? And another example for this is Mata Sita. Mata Sita, she created herself as a small baby in a box. And she didn't born from mother womb, and she didn't child. She disappeared into the earth. She come from earth. She created herself as a small baby and she disappeared. And she never born and never died. So that is how Ishitva and Vashitva. Vashitva means control over nature and five elements. We can do those work according, we can do those five elements according to your wish. See, that is Vasitva. And we have many examples to understand this wisdom, this Siddhi. I'll remind you one few stories. Like when Buddha traveled on his way, he saw many animals tied to kill in Yajna. The animals tied there to, they're going to kill those animals in a yajna, that jantu bali, they're going to kill those. And they tried to, and Buddha went there and he tried to convey those people who is doing this yajna, it is not good to kill any animal. He explained higher truth that ahimso paramo dharmaha, and by killing animals, you are not really able to get any good to the society. You are doing this yajna for make some good energy, right? But by killing these animals, you are not able to make any good energy. That is himsa. Himsa will create bad energy and negative karma. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha, our immediate duty, the uttama dharma is ahimsa. We are not allowed to and kill any animal, my friends. Every life is equal. How your life is, your life is equal to a chick life, a cow life, a pig life. You are not superior than any animal. Every life is equal. We don't have any right to kill them. But he tried to explain a lot, but that foolish people not ready to listen to Buddha. Then he said, without my permission, you can't lit this fire to start this yajna. And he had that Vashitva Siddhi. And they tried so many ways to lead the fire on to start that yajna. they use so many kind of methods, matchbox and bringing the fire. No matter what they do, they're not able to, they can't. They tried so many ways, but they can't. They're not able to lit the fire on. And this is how Vasitva Siddhi works. With the intention of Buddha, they are not able to lit the fire on. Five elements will listen to our statement. That is how Vasitva Siddhi. Another example, as we all know, the Sai Baba light up lamps with water. There are so many kinds of siddhis, my dear friends. By knowing about all these siddhis, we understand our divinity, our absolute power, infinite nature of ourselves, and our supernatural powers, etc. And we are more powerful than what we think, my dear friends. From limited consciousness to how we align ourselves into that ultimate and divine consciousness, we reconnect with our divine consciousness through meditation. Oh my God, it's a wonderful journey, my dear friends. And to know more about various kinds of siddhis, I suggest you to read Autobiography of Yogi by Yogananda Paramahamsa. He met lot of yogis from his childhood, and he describes so many kinds of siddhis. One yogi stay with two bodies. Many kinds of siddhis is there in that book. And one should know and understand these siddhis to know our divinity, but we shouldn't meditate on them, my dear friends. Our ultimate goal is not getting those siddhis. Our ultimate goal is to be with that divine nature. We are not allowed to meditate on siddhis. The critical thing we should understand is we are here to attain enlightenment. We are here to not attain siddhis, my dear friends. According to our life purpose, our work, those supernatural purpose, those siddhis may come to us. May not come. If you have that siddhi, if you need that siddhis to fulfill your life purpose, you will get those siddhis. But you don't need, you really don't get them. Now, our enlightenment does not depend or defined by siddhis we get, my dear friends. It is all about wisdom, understanding, love, and unconditional love. But these siddhis may come or may not come. So there are no rules. We can get siddhis. We may attain enlightenment without getting any supernatural powers. Even though you get some siddhis, you ended up without enlightenment. Not that means if you get siddhi, you are enlightened. No, my dear friends. For example, Ravana, he focused on siddhis rather than enlightenment. In his meditation practice, he focused on siddhis. He get many kinds of siddhis, but he ended up with bad experience. He ended his life as a bad example. And Rishi Vishwamitra, he get many kind of siddhis. Initially, he failed to use those siddhis for higher purpose and higher good. So he can't attain enlightenment. So he is not called as Brahmarshi initially. But then he realized and he started focus on enlightenment rather than siddhis. After that, he used his power for only world welfare, not for his a show off or anything. So we must focus on and use our powers for higher good, for loka kalyan, my dear friends. Only use your powers for the higher good, not for show off. Don't be arrogant or don't show off your siddhis. If you do that, we become corrupt and all those siddhi vanished from your energy system. The most important thing that siddhis are living in this present moment, being compassionate, being grateful, helping people, and vibrating love, practicing awareness and respecting all. This is where we need to focus. And siddhis may come. If siddhis came to you, you can use them for the higher good, my dear friends, and may not come. If you don't get any siddhi, doesn't that mean you not get enlightenment? Enlightenment is not defined by siddhis. If we practice like that, like being in this present moment, compassion, being grateful, helping people, vibrating love energy, if you practice like that, then you know what happened? So we use our siddhis like Lord Hanuma. No matter how senior you are, always kept in mind that there is a lot to know. There is no end to wisdom learning, my dear friends. Our life is a great gift. Make a best use out of this life. Activate great things and enjoy every second of your life. And enjoying every second of your life is enlightenment. And do acting out with that enlightenment, with that wisdom is perfection, my dear friends. We attain those enlightenment and perfection from Mata Siddhidhatri Devi. By awakening these energies, we awaken that Siddhidhatri energy within us. We become like a Siddhidhatri Devi. So let's do meditation, my dear friends. We learned a lot today about Siddhidhatri Devi. Please close your eyes, clasp your fingers, cross your foot, and be with your breath. Be with your normal, natural, easy, soft flow of breathing. Our life is a great gift, my dear friends. Varalakshmi.
Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham Vagisarchitamurya Padukam. Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham.
Our life is a great gift for us.
Padmakara Padmasana Samstha Padmanabha Hrut Padma Mandira Padma Mukim Padma Shureswari Padmini Mahapadma Vanakrutam Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham Vagi Sarchita Murya Padukam Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham Gruhagata Sampad Kirti Vardhini Gruhalakshmi Svagruha Samvasa Iha Parasukada Nirupama Falada Graha Dosha Haranugraha Kara Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham Pagi Sachita Murya Padukam Sri Varalakshmi Chintayamyaham.
Be with your breath, my dear friends. Last few seconds, be with your breath. Connect yourself with that Siddhidhatri energy, my dear friends. Siddhidhatri Devi energies are perfection and enlightenment. Slowly place your both hands on your eyes for 4 seconds. Touch your eyes with your fingertips gently. And whenever you're ready to open your eyes, take your hands up and open your eyes. Wonderful, my dear friends. Thank you for participating with us in this wonderful journey. See you tomorrow. Thank you so much.